For those of you who haven't taught in the last 10 years, Kristen will be able to stay around afterwards and explain what some of those words mean. Our next speaker is Gary Geswein, a 1969 and graduate of agricultural education. He taught at Franklin Community, Crothersville, and restarted the program at North Harrison. Upon his retirement from North Harrison, he started the agriculture program at Lanesville. Gary has worked for the Indiana Department of Education as a consultant and state young farmer executive. Gary most recently served as president of the Agricultural Alumni Association. Gary is one of a number of our alumni who regularly give back to Purdue Education, and he's going to briefly highlight a very unique opportunity we have at this time. Gary?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dan. My role this evening is to kind of add to the future of agriculture education and what maybe your role might be in that. As Dan explained, I had a lot of varied experiences throughout my career and been extremely lucky. Thanks to Dr. Klaus and his patience what to do with a student in Purdue in the 60s, and it didn't really expire to be brilliant during his Purdue career. We was able to have him guide us in the correct direction, I guess is the way to say that. All the way to my retirement and the people that we work with now, even during retirement at Purdue, and Jay, part of that program, and the things that you're involved with throughout the College of Agriculture is an important part of that that we aspire to. A lot of us, and one thing with some person wiser than me, which is most people, is a situation where it says, hey, you always take away from somebody that you meet or associate with or know a little bit of that person. And I think I've done that over the years, and it's been a fantastic benefit. The speakers before us this evening have inspired that much more brilliantly than I could, and I think that's my part of doing that. I think the teachers and the celebration during the professional groups that we had and the fun things we done with Leon and all the things that he alluded to as a profession was able to keep my sanity, basically, through all the activities that you deal with and the trials and tribulations that you have in agriculture education. Wouldn't change a thing. I was lucky. But I don't think I'd change a thing. Oh yeah, things weren't always perfect, but we were extremely lucky. We had people that influenced us throughout, a lot of people in this room, from fellow classmates in my high school to people that that work with me even to this day. And I think a lot of them influenced my son and daughter that went to Purdue. Jean and I appreciate that. Some of you are in this room. And professors at Purdue, not only in ag education so much, but just the influence you had in them. So we've been lucky through all that. And one of the things that we deal with, and Jean and I, my wife, decided a few years ago to help ensure some needs for students that are in ag education at Purdue by starting an endowment. Some of you are aware of that. Others in this room have started endowments. If I go to start names, I'll probably forget someone. But as you deal with that, they've established that also in scholarships and activities. And we've had a very positive experience with that. You kind of go into that with some trepidation, I guess is one word that you would say, and how it would work out. But we've had a very positive experience the way we have set that and worked with that. And I guess what we would do, and other people have seen that benefit and established and worked with students through their own way and their own feelings on that. I guess one of the things that's come up is another opportunity to do that, and that's one reason what we're up here tonight is to mention that they also have a matching program, and where to set up any kind of scholarship, it takes $25,000, but there's a matching program now available that will take care of half of that. So your $12,500 would be what you would involve with to start a program. And that even could be, I guess I understand it, and I don't know all the details, but that could be done over 5 years. So you're talking, looking at a minimal amount each year. Some of you still contribute, and it's something you might consider. Again, we've been very lucky through our experiences in ag education and all the involvements there, and we feel positive about that. I'm not a storyteller, and I can't remember them all anymore in dealing with all that, but my experiences and the activities with all of you in this room, and most of you I've worked with in some form or another, and I can't fool you. A lot of you be my bosses, as I tell a lot of people, and all that. But this is one of the activities that we felt was a positive thing that will help ag education in the future and ensure some things that go on. And a lot of you have done some work in this area specifically, and you know who you are. But we encourage you to take a look at that. See either Dan Gottschalk, Joe, you're back there in development. We found those people to work with us very well. And this is part of today's university. And things will change on the funding and the things that happen. You've seen all the headlines that deal with that, and that's just one of the small parts that maybe we could play in ensuring that ag education has the brilliant people that we want and want to get and continue the program that we'd like to see. So thank you for listening, and appreciate all the help, and I sure thank you for the opportunity to have this celebration here and letting us be a small part of that. Thank you.